Okay. Show me.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Dutch Cheat Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. Well, welcome back. Maybe this is your first video of mine. Welcome. In this video, I'm gonna give you a Christmas present tip. You've seen the title of this video. Over here in the Northern Hemisphere, it's fall, and before you know it, it'll be Christmas. Right? So, if you have kids, or maybe you are a kid, you might be looking for Christmas presents already. Yeah, so there you go. I'll actually do more videos with Christmas present tips, ideas, if you will. And this is my first one. Now, this box is from Double E, I think. Yeah, quite a well-known brand, I think. I've come across quite a lot of sets from them. And it's obviously a brick-based toy, right? Just like Lego is, it is compatible with Lego, meaning that the bricks this set is built out of, you can use these bricks together with Lego bricks if you'd so want to. And immediately you'd think, well, is this a clone? Is this a copy of a Lego set? It is not. For as far as I can tell, at least. This is not a Lepin, whatever, set. As you can see, double E. And as you probably know, Lepin makes real copies, clones of Lego sets, and I don't endorse that at all. So, yeah, I did some research and I couldn't come across this set from Lego. Yeah. Also, this channel, Dutch RC, is about remote controlled toys, right? So, what is a brick-based toy doing on this channel? Well, it is actually remote controlled, this tank. As you can see, it looks like a tank, an Abrams tank. And it is actually controlled by 2.4 gigahertz. And that might not mean anything to you, but that's pretty common in hobby-grade RCs. Some Lego sets are, for as far as I know at least, infrared controlled, which isn't as good. Is that fair to say? I think so. For instance, if you'd want to drive this car outdoors, you should be able to. Yeah, I'm not sure if you'd want to, making the set all dirty and stuff, but should be possible. Now, I got this set from Funnyroot. Funnyroot? I had never heard of Funnyroot, and chances are neither have you. Yeah, so how did this set end up here? Why did I order it from Funnyroot, right? A couple of weeks ago, I got an ad in my Gmail of this set from Funnyroot, and I love the looks of this set. Very impressive. I've actually been in the army, that was a couple of ages ago, and I was in a tank battalion, right? We drove Leopard tanks. This model over here is modeled after an Abrams tank, so not the exact tanks I used to work with, but it's a tank nonetheless, and in my opinion, it looks good. And here comes the stupid part. I will actually not be building the tank. Yeah. As you can see over here, it is a two-in-one set. So that means that from this set, from the content of this box, you can build two models, and I'll build a secondary model. And I'll show you that secondary model in a couple of minutes. And I liked it a little bit better than the tank. But, well, if you want to build a tank, you can build a tank, obviously. And other than some other sets, actually other than a lot of other sets, also from Lego, this box contains the building instructions for both these two models. Very good. You'll see a lot of build instructions come with this model. Yeah. Okay, in this video I'll obviously show you the content of this box. And I'll show you the build model and I'll tell you what I think of that build model. If you are new to my channel, you might not have seen my time-lapse build of this model. I'll put a link up there to my time-lapse build video if you want to check out how it goes together. I'll also tell you what my experience was while building it, if it fits well, if the consistency of the blocks is good, if the consistency of the coloring of the panels and blocks is good. Very important. As you probably know, if you are into these systems, the consistency of the colors and the fit and finish of the blocks, the components in Lego sets is very good. So I definitely want to know, and you should also want to know, if that's good with this EE model. What more can I tell you? Yeah, I think the box art looks great. It's a very big box. It has a carrying handle and it's a really big set, this 1500 pieces. That's nothing to sniff about, right? There is obviously a link in the description of this video to this set, and it's not the cheapest of sets. Yeah, it's also a big set, so I think if it goes together well and if the consistency of all the parts is good, the price is warranted, but we'll see. Okay, what more can I tell you? Ages 8 and up, I don't know. Might be legitimate because it's a pretty big set and it has electronics in it. Yeah, 8 and up should be okay. Let me see. Over here there's a smaller picture of the secondary model, which is more of an artillery set, as you can hopefully see. Actually, I'll put up a picture of this secondary model right now, so you can have a look at that. In a minute though, I'll show you, as mentioned before, the finished model, and we'll see how everything worked out. First though, let's have a look how things are packaged. Okay, so we open up the box over here, and in the box we find another box. Can I get it out? I can. One box and another box. Two boxes within the box. You know what? I'm gonna empty these two boxes and then I'll show you what the content looks like. Alright guys, understatement of the year. We've got a lot of stuff here. And well, it's a 1500 pieces set, so that was to be expected, of course. But well, it's always impressive to see all the pieces of such a big set. Now what surprised me a little bit was the amount of electronics you get. Quite a lot. A lot of motors. One motor, two motor, three motor, four motor, five motor. Five motors, that's it, yeah. And we've got a receiver box from the looks of it. And another one, another receiver. Oh, okay. Oh, well, another receiver. Okay, a battery box. Well, that was to be expected. Cool stuff. And a lot of bags with all the components, all the parts. And I have to say that everything is packaged well. However, as you might have noticed, the bags have a number on them, two. But that's just the number from the box they came out of. As you notice, there was a box one and a box two. this one came out of box 2, and this one came out of box 2, and this one came out of box 2. Here's one from box 1. So the bags aren't referenced in the build instructions. If you've ever built Lego sets, you might be accustomed to the build instructions referencing the actual bags you need to use parts out of. So in this double E set, you don't get that. Is that a big minus of this set? I don't think so. If you've ever built bigger Lego sets, such as this one, or other brick-based brands, the best way of building a set is getting all bags into bins, plastic bins, to sort. For instance, I've got a bag with larger bars, and I throw those together with these larger bars and sort them out, right? That'll speed up your build process quite a bit. So that's what I'll do. So in that sense, I don't think the bags not being numbered isn't a negative thing. You tell me what you think, of course. Okay, again, I've done a separate build video, and now we're gonna jump cut to the build model. Here we go. So, by the powers of video editing, we now have ourselves a nice and a quite impressive model tank. Yeah, is it a big model? Yeah, it's quite a big model, and that figures 1500 pieces. You won't end up with a small set, obviously. And let me see. It took me approximately 6 to 8 hours. I didn't really keep track of time, but it takes a good amount of time to build a set like this, obviously. The instructions were more than clear. They were perfect, basically. I couldn't have asked for better instructions. They were 100% clear, and nowhere in the manual was I left thinking, well, do I need that part or that part, and how does it go together? Perfect, basically. So, kudos. Now, the nice thing is, actually, that during the time I built this this model, the price actually went down. Take a look at the link in the video description. Funny Root apparently decided to lower the price on this set. So by now it's really a nice tip, in my opinion. It's quite affordable for what you get here. It's approximately, at the time of the shooting of this video, approximately 100 euros. I don't know what that equates to in dollars. $115 maybe? Well, you'll have to look it up yourself. Okay, so the quality. The build, the model is designed well. It's constructed well. It's rigid. You can easily pick it up at all kinds of places. It won't fall apart on you. There are obviously a few things that can reasonably easily be knocked off, like these antennas. Well, that's basically the only parts that really easily come off. And to me, that's not really a problem. Anything else on this model is built is designed well. So the construction is designed well. So kudos for Double E. This is the first set I have from Double E, and it's designed well. The parts. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that in the video. The consistency of the coloring of the parts is good, is excellent. Actually, I can't see any variation in colors. Not in the green parts. You'll be able to see that most easily, I'd say. But all gray parts are exactly the same color. Black, red, everything, the color consistency of this model, of their parts, is good. The quality of their parts, everything fits together well, so that's good. The finish, the look of some parts, it's not bad, but if you are accustomed to the quality of Lego parts, I left this plate over here in full view because this plate looks, well, I'm not sure what the word is, but yeah, it's a little more matte, has a bit more of a matte finish, especially compared to this block, these blocks over here. I'm pretty sure you'll be able to see that. It's not horrible in any stretch of the imagination, but again, it's well, if you'd say that a Lego set, the blocks or the parts in the Lego set are a 10 out of 10, I'd say this is a 9 out of 10. Or, well, yeah, 9 out of 10. I think that's fair to say. So it's far from horrible, it's far from bad, and the price of this set is far lower than what you'd pay for a Lego set, so it makes sense. But, yeah, it's not 100% Lego. There you go. Okay, what more can I tell you about this set? Yeah, I did have quite a number of spare parts, or leftover parts. These are the leftover parts. There were actually more. These antennas weren't in the instructions. I've added them myself. Let me see. These, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see them, but these grills over here. Oh, actually, can I move this out of the way? No. These grills I've added myself. Those parts weren't used. And the tracks. It's a tracked vehicle, obviously. I had two spare tracks. Can be handy for spares if you damage one. But I've added them to the model. In real life, a tank would have a couple of spare tracks mounted on it. Well, not, maybe not always, but in some cases, the spare track parts will be mounted on the actual tank. Makes sense, right? So you have them with you if you need to do repairs on your tank. Now, as this is a remote controlled model, what can you actually make it do, right? I didn't know from the website. The Funny Root website doesn't tell you what this thing can do. It can obviously drive, right? And turn. But what other functions does this model have? Well, let me show you again. It can drive back and forth, it can steer, it can pivot on the spot, like a real life tank would be able to do. So that's good. It's is it noisy? It is noisy. And yeah. I think that makes sense for a tracked vehicle, right? A real life tank will be very noisy, far, far noisier than this one. Okay, so that's the first function, if you will, that it has. Secondly, the entire turret can turn almost 180 degrees. It can't keep on turning. But that's the range of motion it has until here. And physically, I think it would have been possible to make it an endless loop, to make it turn and turn until Kingdom Come, right? But there is an electronics cable running from the turret down to the power brick, right? Because this turret has its own motors and receiver, so there's obviously a cable running from this upper deck, the turret, down to the chassis. So if they would have made this a 180 turnable turret, yeah, at some point that cable would get snagged, right? So I think they made the right choice by not enabling you to just keep on turning until that cable just gets damaged. Okay, So that's the second function. Third function is this. You can raise and lower the guns, which is great. I was hoping it would be able to do this. But actually the sound of the motor and gearing added with the motion, it fits together well, this. I think the speed of this is realistic as well. But it's especially great that this model has this function. Very, very nice. Now, it has one other function. Let me turn the turret. Over here, you can see two red dots, right? Which are, yes, they are pretty unrealistic. You wouldn't have red dots over there on a real tank, or is this a tank artillery or whatever? So these are spring-loaded missiles. This is what those missiles look like, and they're exactly the same as what LEGO themselves use, right? So these two-tone gray blocks you see here have a spring in them, and there is a mechanism, the fourth motor is used for that, which triggers them, and they shoot far, quite far, further than I had expected, at least 6 meters. Did I mention that you get 4 spares, so you get a total of 8 of these rockets, if you will, bolts, projectiles, and again, they shoot very, very far. And I'm gonna try demonstrating that to you, but it's a very quick, fast action. You probably won't be able to see that, but let's give it a try. Here we go. There. And now I'll have a nice adventure trying to find those again. Yeah, cool. All right, guys, what more can I tell you about this EE tank? Detailing, subject to personal taste, probably. I think they struck a nice balance in not making it too busy, if you will. But there's quite a lot of detailing on this model, and there are certain things you can change in its appearance. So you can change these launchers over here, the angle of these launchers over here, and the direction. You can change the direction and the angle of this radar dish, and that's all very nice. This one over here, just a little. And it has a lot of power functions, actually more than I was hoping for. Obviously, I hoped the turret would be movable, and I hoped the guns would be movable, but that it could actually shoot, I had not expected. It's not something I was looking for either, but for kids, that's probably a bonus. Let me see. I'm not sure if you'll be able to properly see that, but the tracks actually have suspension in them. Each wheel is sprung. So if you run over things, the suspension will actually show that it's moving. So that's nice and makes for a realistic look, I think. I would have liked these drapes, if you will, the side covers to come down a little more. Maybe this is actually realistic for an Abrams tank, I'm not even sure. But again, I would have, obviously they wanted that sprung suspension to be visible, as it's a selling point. But I would have liked that to be out of view. Yeah, just me, of course. But at the rear you've got some grill detailing, lights. The model does not have LED, so no lighting. That would have definitely been nice, but it would have made the model more expensive as well. And that's about it. Oh, if you turn the turret 90 degrees clockwise or anti-clockwise, you can actually open the hood, this, and that'll give you, grant you access to the electronics. Not really necessary once it's up and running, but maybe that's handy. And that's about it. That's my take on this double E Abrams tank that I got from Funny Root. Again, at the current price, I think it's actually fair to say that it is a bargain for what you get. So do check it out if you have kids, or again, if you are a kid. Might be a nice idea for the Christmas holidays. Tell me what you think, of course. We've got a comment section down below on YouTube. Well, I'd like to hear from you what you think of this rendition by Double E. Thank you very much for watching. Catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.